Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's discuss the general idea of how a mass spectrometer works in simple terms. Running a mass spectrum begins with introducing the sample molecule into the mass spectrometer. Often a tiny sample of the molecule or mixture is injected into a heated port. The sample boils, vaporizes, and the gas is swept into the ionizer. The molecule M passes through a beam of electrons, this red dotted line. When one of these high energy electrons collides with a molecule in the sample, an electron in the sample molecule can be displaced, literally kicked out of the molecule. This ionization process is called electron impact. Upon losing an electron, the parent molecule becomes a positively charged cation. Since organic molecules typically have an even number of electrons, electrons are found in pairs, bonding pairs and lone pairs, loss of an electron results in a radical as well as a cation, a radical cation. So we represent the radical cation of our parent molecule as M dot plus. We'll call this species the parent ion. The energy involved in ionization is often high enough to not just ionize, but also break the molecule apart. This is fragmentation. When a parent ion, a radical cation, fragments, it normally breaks into a fragment cation and a different fragment, fragment prime, radical. Note that the mass of these two pieces is collectively equal to the mass of the parent ion. So to recap, we now have a gas that contains some parent ion, a radical cation, and possibly a mixture of fragment cations and fragment radicals. This gas passes through a magnetic field. Here is where things get interesting. The parent ion and fragment cation are both charged, and moving in the field will feel a force from the magnetic field. The force is proportional to the size of the charge, Z. Both the parent and fragment ions are plus one in charge, Z equals plus one, so both feel the same force. What happens then? Based on physics, force equals mass times acceleration, the force will cause the parent ion and fragment cation to be accelerated, and the direction of their travel will be changed. While the force on both is the same, their masses are different, so the curvature of their paths will also be different. The heavier parent ion will be diverted less than the lighter fragment cation. The mass spectrometer contains a detector that can measure the impact of charged particles. The position of the impact on the detector determines each particle's mass to charge value, or M to Z. Based on where the charged particle impacts, the mass of the particle can be determined. Therefore, the MS can determine the mass of the parent ion as well as the fragment cations. How about the fragment radical? Because it is neutral, Z equals zero, its path remains straight and it will not be detected. Designing a mass spectrometer is very difficult, but the physics that govern the instrument are actually very simple. We have now explained the basic ideas of how a mass spectrometer can measure the mass of a molecule and its fragments. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Take care.